Warning, travelling to Iran could damage your freedom. That's the warning the UK's Foreign Office issued in a recent statement. There is a risk that British nationals, and a higher risk that British-Iranian dual nationals, could be arbitrarily detained in Iran. All British nationals should consider carefully the risks of travelling to Iran. This comes as bad news for Hassan Rouhani and his allegedly moderate administration, which had been set to improve Tehran's diplomatic relationship with the rest of the world in the face of the increasing sanctions imposed by Trump and the USA. Rouhani had promised to increase tourism to Iran, partly in hope of improving the economy. He recently tweeted, "Our approach to develop hashtag tourism sector is to develop ground for private sector. We welcome Iranian investors, both home and abroad." Despite Iranian-UK diplomatic ties, the UK remain aware of the dangers UK citizens face travelling to Iran. The UK government is in dispute with Iran over British citizen Nazanin Zaghari Ratcliffe. Zaghari Ratcliffe, a journalist with the Thomson Reuters Foundation, and her young daughter had their passport confiscated. She is now serving a 2-year jail sentence. The UK have offered goodwill towards Iran, increasing trade, reopening its embassy, supporting the nuclear deal. In return, Tehran have continued their hostage-taking policy. Since Western nations improved their diplomatic relations with Iran, there has been an increase in the number of foreigners spending time in Iranian jails. The US State Department, aware of the increased risk to US travelers, stated, "Iran has continued to harass, arrest, and detain US citizens, in particular dual nationals." Tehran's objectives? They're using hostages as political pawns to influence foreign governments and trying to force foreign governments to grant trade or financial favours. Iran offered to release Zaghari Ratcliffe in exchange for $530 million debt relief. They also extracted $400 million from Obama in a prisoner exchange. The regime wants their people to remain ignorant of Western values. Supreme Leader Ali Khamenei said the revolution's biggest threat is Western culture and ideology, fearing it would drive Iran's youths into rebellion. Foreigners need to remain wary of travelling to the Islamic Republic. Taking hostages clearly is part of Iran's current foreign policy, and Tehran is always hungry for more. It is perhaps time for the UN to hold Iran to account.